Mopar fam, I hope everybody's having a blessed day. We are here at Moparty. This is Sunday at Moparty, and we have frostbite right here and storm. Both trucks, a lot of people's been asking for it. Well, right there, we have a dyno. Now, I don't know how accurate the dyno is going to be. This is a mobile dyno, but we're going to do it. We're going to put frostbite and storm on the dyno, and we're going to see what they do. So wish us luck, let's do it. All right, we got Project Storm getting on the dyno. We'll see what happens, guys. Yes, both of them are going to be loud, especially mine because the pipe's going right in the tent. Here we go, guys.
Screaming. got heat soaked. All right, I'll print this out here for you.
All right.
Then it comes out of there. So the best one was 401
and 424 torque.
Not bad, not bad. No winter cooler, just meth. She's on. Alright, Frostbite's going on the dyno for the first time in its life. Do on the first pass,
okay,
run the nitrous on it. On the second pass, just flip that switch off. I want to see what it does on the motor.
Sounds good. All
right. Bottle on first pass, no bottle on the second one. Huh? Just turn the switch off though. So if his is reading 400, then I'm thinking it's low. It's probably gonna read 475, 500, maybe 500. We'll see. I guess we're gonna find out what a good transmission and a big insert is. And a camshaft. I'm thinking with the spray, it's gotta put down at least 550. It just goes. I don't know, it goes out of the hole. You can have all the power you want, but if it ain't getting to the ground, it don't matter. I've never done this before. What's the pressure really need to be around to do these
things?
We
really just make sure, as long as they're above 20 for these type of tires and they're even, we're good.
Okay.
A lot of times why we even check them is just to make sure they're even, because otherwise they'll have a really weird
balance or something.
Yeah,
like
yeah.
Second vehicle and the vehicle.
Dillon Derby?
Yeah. If I wasn't scared, I'd tell him to run it to 7, but...
So what was it for?
I don't know. I didn't even look.
Hey, let's have a good one.
Ah.
I'll print this out here for you.
I'm sorry. Nervous. I ain't never been on one of these things. I always see so many bad things happen.
Man, that's all you see on the line, yeah. I mean, honestly, it's easier to do it on here than do it on the track.
Really?
You know, that roller only weighs 2,200 pounds compared to what your vehicle is. Worst thing I've been really on here is a drive shaft. But if you have an accurate drive shaft, you're fine.
That's a stock drive shaft.
Oh, part. Really?
But I've never. It's the 8 speeds that are the ones that have the drive shaft.
Yeah. There you go.
Appreciate it, bud.
Alright guys, we just did the dyno with Frostbite. We're coming off the dyno. It's still in one piece, so I'm happy about that. Now, we only ran the truck to 6,000 RPM on the first one, and we ran it to 6,200 on the second pass. And we ended up doing 538 on the first pass, 558 torque, and we did 549 second pass, and 551 torque on the second run. So I'm happy. We at least have some numbers for the first time with Frostbite ever, so we'll continue to go. Project Storm did good. We got just over 400 horsepower to the wheels, which we were kind of guessing somewhere between the 4 to maybe 430 range, give or take. And that's pretty good. No intercooler on Storm. That was just water meth. And it's hot out here, guys, that's for sure. So I'm happy with the numbers so far. We'll continue to grow. Let's go check out some more stuff.